Rightio, so enough people should know by now, this is what I do in my spare time. I like to video myself for the purpose of putting it onto YouTube. So this is the first time in forever that I've taken it on almost exclusively of a Monday morning to do this, to actually talk straight to my GoPro and talk to you about what's going on. Alrighty, so it's been a pretty tough morning. I've had a bit of a stomach ache. Needless to say, I've had to take a day off work and I've not been able to go on the dolphin watch, which I really, really like to have gone on. But look, we're going to go and do something, go for a quick walk. We're going to put on Marilyn Henderson's radio program and we'll do a few other things, meet with some people, and I'll show you part of the journey. Yeah, I'm feeling a lot better after. Okay, so many of you would know that one of my main occupations here in Kangaroo Island is window washing. I do that with Justin Van Zyl for the most part, but with my own window washing business, I stick mostly around Kingscote and Brownlow and just Dover Farm maybe. But my point is this: over the last few nights, I've been watching mowing channels do lawn mowing for free that offer it to gardens where the grass has grown excessively high and clearly needs to be removed. So they do it for free on the basis that you guys watch, or like people like me watch them and make the money out of ad revenue, which is clearly a great idea. And as a consequence, the yards get a massive clean up and new lease on life. I'm contemplating offering that here in KI. The reason being is that I'm actually set up to do that. I've got lawn mowers, whippersnippers, a whole host of tools for that very purpose. I can even do hedge trimming. I've got a 9 foot, I think actually close to 12 foot high hedge trimmer with the top leans over so I can do the top edge as well. I'm contemplating setting that up, but I'm always looking out for a new property to do that to, where I sort of know the owners, so we're working on that. So look forward out. Hopefully you'll see some videos like that in the near future. Radio. I've collected the USB from the radio presenter and I'm going back to put it live onto the radio station in the next 20 minutes to half an hour. Normally it starts about 11, sometimes 11:30, and it's a country radio program by Marilyn Henderson and it runs right through until around 3:30 in the afternoon. We can do this, not that bad. Hopefully my stomach will feel better a little bit later in the day. But a definite upside of walking around over driving or riding a bike, although riding a bike is pretty cool as well, as you all know I ride a Super 73, there's a definite upside of walking is I get to see empty blocks like this one. Yeah, they've been empty for a long time. I've been living here since that one was empty. So I know, so I'm taking the scenic route to get back to the radio station, going past a few houses, friends and people I know. I've learnt if you can't see your reflection, I'm pretty sure the windows are still dirty. It's actually really good to be able to live in a time where I can talk to a camera without anybody questioning my sanity. A few years ago when I did try doing this, when I first came to the island, I had people who literally yelled out something like, put the camera down, you c-. Yes, I swore. So now it's 2021 and we can do this. Any downside to vlogging in a public area like this is the sound of traffic, the sound of lawnmowers, and other things going on. Which I guess is what you've got to deal with. This is why I'm probably going to try and get the GoPro 10, which I hope has both a microphone jack and a headphone jack, so that I can actually talk to myself satisfactorily and knowing that you can hear me. I've just seen another house where the windows need a severe cleanup. So what I've really got to do is thank you guys for continuing to watch my channel. Amazing to watch my channel grow slowly but surely. I went from only about 25 members only 2 years ago. I'm now sitting at about 77. I'd love to reach 100. I'd still really love to reach 1,000, but let's just see where the future takes us. So I've just seen somebody wearing earplugs walking down the road. They were talking to themselves, but without a camera. So there's nothing in front of them to show what they're talking to. Now, 20 years ago when I lived in Adelaide, anybody did that was seen as a crazy person or severely, you know, intoxicated. And it happened. Adelaide City had a few who would do that all day long. But over here, it's 2021, 2022 is just around the corner, and every man and his dog has some sort of earplug where they can talk to themselves, but the microphone's only about here. All right, I'm going to move on. I might have to put a mask on in a second. Let's see how this turns out. Okay, so I ended up at the coffee shop just around the corner here and moved on to the radio station, but I'll play that in the next video. For now, here's some footage I created for the Dolphin Watch of KI and Victor Harbour. To see more videos like this, remember to watch every video right through, punch that like button, smash the subscribe button, and kick that notification bell right in the